My name is Susan Tsai. I am a minimal invasive gynecologic surgeon at Northwestern Medicine. Our patient today is a 44-year-old woman with two children who has been experiencing really heavy bleeding for quite some time. She had other procedures in the past, including an endometrial ablation, which is a burning of the lining inside with the goal of having a more normal period. However, that didn't work for her. She had a large fibroid on the posterior surface of her uterus, so it really angled up her entryway into the uterus, which made it difficult. So I'm not sure if she really got burned in that previous procedure, and hence why maybe it failed for her. So in today's surgery, after counseling, we've opted to proceed with a robotic-assisted total laparoscopic hysterectomy, bilateral self-injectomy cystoscopy. And so knowing about her two prior cesarean sections, I prefer to use the robot because the robot allows us to have more of a 3D look inside, which is much clearer and crisper. We don't know what that scar tissue looks like until we are into the abdomen or able to visualize it, but we have seen uteruses stuck to and plastered to the backside of the abdomen, and we've got to unplaster it before we can actually start the surgery. So I do find it's a better tool sometimes to help us see those planes better and get into unplastering the uterus from the abdominal wall.
So we just got into the abdomen. The first initial needle placement was to insufflate the belly. So it just gives us room to work. Dr. Monty then placed this initial trocar. It's an optical trocar, so you could see all the layers of the abdominal wall and that we're going through, and then entry into the abdomen.
So we're just trying to see where the best spots to put these other trocars are.
So this is the Da Vinci Xi, and is a multi-port robot. Each of these will hook up to these metal trocars that we've placed, and then through these incisions, we will place instruments through there. So the camera is locked into place right now. We're just gonna press this little button, and we're gonna push our camera in. Oh, so she's got a lot of scarring back there, huh? Okay, all right, let's sit. So I actually think Dr. Yu has the hardest part of the surgery. She is moving the uterus with what we call a uterine manipulator. So she's kind of angling at different positions so I can see particular portions of the uterus better. And I always say that's the person that really is dictating our whole case. At this point, she's kind of showing me the blood vessel on her right side. So someone, whether or not we do it robotically or laparoscopically, is always moving that uterus. This area looks a little bit red. We think what's happened is there's blood that went out backwards the fallopian tube and ended up over here. And that could be a process of her ablation. Unfortunately, there are some ablation devices that don't ablate all the inside of our uterus. So we can leave pockets of active tissue, and they tend to be near the fallopian tubes. So I wonder if her blood from menstruation went backwards and ended up in these little pockets here. Great, perfect. I'm just gonna just buzz these little extra blood vessels she has to this fibroid. So scarring from C-sections can be nothing, and people heal beautifully and we never find anything. We have lately been seeing the uterus, which should be kind of like in the middle of the abdomen, actually stuck to the top of the belly. And in this case, it's not coming down as nicely, and so we're trying to find the plane to take it down without making a hole in. So I always tell patients it's like peeling a sticker off a peel pack. Should be really nice and easy. Hers was not, so evidence of somebody's been there. In her case, two C-sections, which caused it to be much stickier than normal. So we saw urine spurting, so we know we did not kink it during the suturing of the vagina. So we know we are done, so we're gonna have Rachel take the robot back. So we call this C technique, to take out specimens, and essentially we are kind of almost peeling an apple so that we can get these larger specimens out. And we now do it within a bag, so we call it contained morcellation. So if a piece landed somewhere that then gave it a blood supply, it could grow also, and you could have recurrence of fibroids. but it is a way for us to get bigger specimens out without having to do like C-section scar cuts. People end up, so it's about 3 centimeter incision, heals very nicely.
Do you need another next? So the cervix is the bottom portion of the uterus, is where we do our pap smears. So the manipulator that was placed at the beginning is actually cupping this area. And then
this is her fibroid that was inside. And her fibroid, based on our procedure before, was a fibroid that was what we call submucous fibroid. Hers was partially in the wall, but a lot of it was in the lining. So this is probably what was causing her to have a lot of bleeding. So this one weighed, I think she said 274 grams.
Which is great.